What's up, YouTube? Good to see you guys again. We're here in beautiful Vancouver at White Cliff Park right now. We finally have a perfectly clear, crisp night. It's looking gorgeous. We're gonna do some astronomy, test out a couple cameras on the equatorial mount, zoom in on Andromeda and the Orion Nebula. Those will be our two main targets today. Maybe a couple other things, but those are the goals. And yeah, sunset was beautiful. I'm just gonna get one more flight in before we get going. Time to go. It's a 25-minute drive to Porto Cove with one quick stop for snacks. Six or seven layers up top and three layers on the bottom. I'm about to put my warmer boots on. Step one is always dress very, very warmly. It's about to drop to about minus 10 tonight. So we made it to our spot. Perfectly clear skies in 360 degrees. The sun just set over there. Orion's belt and Orion is there. So that'll be our main target going that direction. And Big Dipper's there and Polaris is up there. Polar scope has to basically be aimed straight at Polaris, the North Star. Now that we have our polar scope aligned, time to set up the rest of the gear and get shooting.
I'm using a Skywatcher EQ5 Pro with GoTo, powered by a Jackery.
This will power everything for days, and I don't have to worry about power since this mount sucks up a good amount of juice. Time to get a camera hooked up to this. So I'm gonna mount a Sony on one side and the Nikon P1000 on the other side.
My goal is to compare what is achievable with each of these cameras.
My favorite feature of the A7IV so far is gotta be this shutter thing that covers the sensor. It makes swapping lenses and cameras so much simpler and so much easier. Okay, next up, we're gonna turn our equatorial mount on. Set all our parameters.
This is called a three-star alignment and helps make sure that the mount is set up properly. I purchased a Sigma 100 to 400 a while back due to its lightweight size, so we will be comparing that to the Superzoom under these crisp stars.
And just like that, we have a successful alignment. This is great news. All right, first test photo, here we go. Woo, baby, that looks great. That is amazing. That is clearly Orion. Wow, that is spectacular. I've never shot astronomy with P1000, so I'm gonna try it for the first time tonight. It's got this crazy stupid thing where it doesn't let you do a bulb mode exposure unless you're in ISO 100. So my expectations are very low, but you never know what you're gonna get until you try it. So here we are.
If I'm able to pull this off with this camera, it could mean not needing to buy a telescope.
All right, well, here goes nothing. It's basically impossible to tell if you're in focus or not, but I'm gonna try like a 4-minute exposure. I don't really know. Maybe it's better than it looks on the screen, but the 1-minute bulb mode limit, as well as the ISO 100 limit for bulb mode, is just ridiculous. So it is what it is. As for the Sony a7 IV, it looks like it's getting some phenomenal images. So I'm gonna keep that one going. And instead of de-rigging and moving to one camera, I'm just gonna let them both go and see how it goes.
Here's a few of the time lapses that the Sonys were able to capture. While I was feeling small amongst the stars, a fellow astronomer came out to join me, and we talked shop for a while. Honestly, this really helped keep me out in the cold as I was starting to lose feeling in my feet. After Orion set on the horizon, I made my way home and passed right out. Thankfully, the weather was good for a few days in a row.
Okay, so we're out here again. I came to the same place, similar gear setup, except I brought a couple extra accessories. And I want to give the P1000 a bit better of a run for its money now that I understand what it can do. Borrowed this astronomy laser pointer, which I'm going to use for a workshop coming up. Pretty cool. Apparently, it can actually hit the moon with light. So I got to make sure to never aim it at satellites or airplanes or anything like that, and to be super safe and responsible with it.
I was able to get a smooth track at 3,000 millimeters for a full 60 seconds. In focus, giving it my best effort just before the camera died from the cold. Unfortunately, it cannot be charged with the Nikon official charger while being used, so I swapped it out for the A7R3 and took a few more photos and was able to catch Andromeda setting on the horizon before packing up and heading home for the night. All right, it's review time. So in this video, I had the Sony a7 IV as well as the Sony a7 R3, along with a Sigma 100 to 400 f5 to f6.3, pitted up against the Nikon P1000 Superzoom camera with the 24 to 3000 millimeter f2.8 all the way up to f8 lens. This may seem like a bit of a random comparison, but for me, I already have all of that Sony and Sigma gear from my professional photo and video work, and I wanted to pit it up against the P1000 just to see what it's capable of, because I've been considering getting a telescope that I can attach my Sonys to, but if this worked out, maybe I wouldn't need to get a telescope, because that 3000 millimeter range is truly incredible. However, I don't think that's going to be the case. So let's get into it. My two targets that I set out to get were Andromeda and Orion. Unfortunately, I was not able to get a single good shot of Andromeda with the P1000. Between the difficult focusing and the battery life, I'm not sure why I was not able to get a single one. So I noticed in the field that it was shooting Orion really well, so I wanted to at least give it the benefit of the doubt. So I focused on Orion for the rest of the review. Starting out, we have a raw image from both cameras, no editing, straight out of camera, the P1000 at 3000 millimeters, and the Sony a7 IV at 600 millimeters, which is the Sigma at 400 with the APS-C crop. I believe that comes to 600. As you can see right away, the P1000 is very dark, whereas the Sony has a lot of light coming in. I was shooting that at ISO 6400, so tons of light coming in. 30 seconds for the time lapses and up to 4 minutes for a single photo exposure, which did get some pretty cool results. I know I have a long way to go when it comes to processing astronomy images. There's a lot of science there. I wanted to keep this simple, so I'm starting out with a basic Lightroom edit, as much as I can do, knowing what I know, to make both images look good. This is something I would do for social media. And right away you can tell that I have to push this P1000 image so far to like +3 or +4 on the exposure slider, giving it some pretty terrible banding, but a shocking amount of data did come out of this image. So I was kind of impressed to see that, like, wow, that is usable, especially on social media. On the Sony side of things, I cropped it to match what the 3000 millimeter frame would look like. And as you can tell, the quality of the raw data is just so much higher. There's so much less noise, even at ISO 6400. And when I push this file to the limits, it holds together a lot better. Moving on, we come to something that's essential for astronomy: stacking photos. So if you don't know, this is where you stack, you take a bunch of photos, you stack them all on top of each other, and then you condense them into one image to get the best possible file. I'm Unfortunately, the P1000 has another software limitation. Shocker. So you can do ISO 100 for one full minute, but there's in-camera noise reduction that you cannot turn off. You can go to minimum or to high, but it takes the same amount of time no matter what. So for each 1 minute exposure, there's 1 minute of dead time where the camera's doing this noise reduction. This makes time-lapsing and getting as many images for stacking as possible and extremely difficult. That combined with the battery dying made it so that I really couldn't get enough photos to stack. So I processed both images anyways. The Sony is stacked and the Nikon is not, but I used astronomy tools, Photoshop actions, as well as some adjustment curves to really push both of these files to the limit and see what was possible to get. So that's what you're seeing here. Overall, I'd say it was a pretty fun experiment. It was a good time out there shooting, but I can't say that I would ever pull the Nikon P1000 out again for this type of astronomy. The Sony, even with only a 400 millimeter lens, did a phenomenal job in comparison. So unless I'm doing moon shots or maybe some planetary imaging, I would consider doing it. I've seen some people get some pretty cool Saturn results. Other than that, I think I'm gonna reach for the Sony every single time, and the Nikon is sadly gonna sit on the shelf for astronomy. I was really impressed by the low light capabilities of the Sony a7 IV. I may even push it past that magic ISO 6400 number moving forward because it was not very noisy at all, especially when stacked. So that'll be interesting to see where I can push and take that camera. That's it for me tonight. I'm gonna call it here. Let me know what you enjoyed about this video and if you want to see any other type of astronomy content in the comments below. I'd love to hear that and get that feedback from you guys. That'd be really appreciated. And if you're actually still watching this video, thank you. And hit that subscribe button if you haven't yet. I'll see you guys next time.